Every civilization needs to protect itself from attack. When swords fail, we use secrets. In 17th century France, a religious war was raging with Protestant Huguenots against Royalist Catholics. The forces of the Catholic King, Louis XIII, surrounded the city, but the Huguenots refused to surrender. The king's forces faced a long battle. But then they intercepted an encrypted letter from a courier. No one could unravel the code. Desperate to decipher the text, the king's men sent for Antoine Rossignol, a young mathematician. He solved it in an hour. The king's general sent the decrypted message to the Huguenots, along with the original letter. The city surrendered without a fight. Antoine became the cryptographer to the throne, mentored by Cardinal Richelieu, who was also a cryptographer. Antoine then mentored his son, Bonaventure, who was wildly inventive. When the next king, Louis XIV, ascended the throne, Bonaventure worked in a study next to the royal chambers. Antoine was by his side. The father and son invented a nearly unbreakable nomenclature and monoalphabetic substitution cipher. Two number tables generating an unpredictable mix of code. They pioneered the use of nulls, misspellings, aliases for keywords, and traps. Each table charted one fixed element and one free element. Finding an element on the first table was easy, but the use of a second table multiplied the variables beyond the ability of technology to decipher them. And so with this layering of code upon code, the great cipher was born. Bonaventure's son continued his father's and grandfather's work, carrying the legacy forward. The great cipher was used to protect France while Louis XIV was young, during the ministership of Richelieu's successor, Mazarin. Building from one generation to the next, the Rossignols helped Louis XIV evolve from a child king into the sun king. But after the king's death, the keys to the code were lost. The great cipher was virtually impossible to decode. So impossible that it took almost 200 years to crack. A military cryptologist, Etienne Bezires, spent 3 years meticulously studying the famous cipher's patterns until he solved a phrase that would unlock the mystery. Today, in our industry, we bravely face our enemies, building on the outstanding achievements of our forebears to protect our civilization from attack. In our centuries-old quest for perfect security, we can't always get what we want, but we try. By coming together year after year to share knowledge, by creating technology, not just for our time, but for all time, by mentoring a new generation of security experts, and by tirelessly working hand in hand to solve the problems of today and tomorrow.